الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. وكنتيني إن شاء الله تعالى with سورة التغابن. سورة التغابن سورة نمبر 64. I think we only did the first آية, right? Only the first, what, the first two? You know, we did the first two. So آية number 3 إن شاء الله. آية number 3 from سورة التغابن سورة نمبر 64. We'll start with the recitation إن شاء الله. Everybody's there. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. خلق السماوات والأرض بالحق. وصوركم فأحسن صوركم. خلق السماوات والأرض بالحق وصوركم فأحسن صوركم وإليه المصير. يعلم ما في السماوات والأرض ويعلم ما تسرون وما تعلنون والله عليم بذات الصدور. يعلم ما في السماوات والأرض ويعلم ما تسرون وما تعلنون والله عليم بذات الصدور. ألم يأتكم نبأ الذين كفروا من قبل؟ ألم يأتكم نبأ الذين كفروا من قبل فذاقوا وبال أمرهم ولهم عذاب أليم. ذلك بأنه كانت تأتيهم رسلهم ذلك بأنه كانت تأتيهم رسلهم بالبينات فقالوا أبشر يهدوننا فكفروا وتولوا واستغنى الله واستغنى الله والله غني حميد. ذلك بأنه كانت تأتيهم رسلهم بالبينات فقالوا أبشر يهدوننا فكفروا وتولوا واستغنى الله والله غني حميد. We look at verse number 3. خلق السماوات والأرض، قائد ذهبي، النقاب الذهبي. خلق السماوات والأرض، همزة إز لايت، بالحق، وصوركم. And we talked that yesterday. Need some training because the waw is light between two heavy letters. The sad is heavy, the ra is heavy. The waw is wasa, wasawara, wasawarakum. Not wasawa, wasawa. And then the ra is heavy. Wasawarakum, fa ahsana suwarakum, wa ilayhi al-masir. Masir, the sad is heavy, and then the ra is light. Masir. Not al-masir. Al-masir. يعلم ما في السماوات والأرض ويعلم ما تسرون the ra is heavy with شدة تسرون وما تعلنون كسرة make it كسرة تعلي والله the waw is light والله the lam is heavy عليم ميم sound تنوين after it باء كلاب عليم بذات الصدور and الصدور make sure that the dal is not dad and the sad is heavy. Say, Wallahu alimun bi dhati as-sudur. Man alam ya'tikum naba'u alladhina kafaru min qablu. This is ikhfa and the heavy. The gunna is heavy because of the qaf. And the ba' with qalqala sukun. من قبل فذاقوا وبال أمرهم ولهم عذاب أليم إظهار ذلك بأنه كانت you see the small waw after the ha so that you stress the dhamma or the ذلك بأنه كانت تأتيهم two ta's becomes one كانت تأتيهم رسلهم like that إخفاء with the ba بالبينات فقالوا مد أبشروي إدغام مضغن أبشروي يهدوننا فكفروا وتولوا واستغنى الله the rain is heavy everything else is light in that word and then Allah is heavy واستغنى الله واستغنى الله والله غني حميد إظهار so since the surah is about التغابن about الغبن which is one of the names of the day of judgment when people will see how much they cheated themselves the sorrow and the loss that they would receive we talked about الغبن this is mainly used in buying and selling when something is extremely expensive and a person doesn't know the value of it and he has it and he sell it with no money and then he realized that he sold the most expensive jewelry for as if it's a piece of glass. So the regret that he would get. This is how people will be in the day of judgment when they see that this life was so precious, but they wasted it. It was so precious to use it for the worship of Allah and to do the good deeds, but they wasted it in the kufr and the sinful life and so on. So then after that, so the ayah number three, خلق السماوات والأرض. The first verses talks about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because everything glorifies Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. خلق السماوات والأرض بالحق. He created the heavens and the earth بالحق. The translation of the ayah first says, He has created the heavens and the earth with truth and He shaped you and made good your shapes and to Him is the final return. Imam Sa'di rahimahullah, he says, فلما ذكر خلق الإنسان المكلف المأمور المنهي ذكر خلق باقي المخلوقات when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the previous verses talked about he's the one that created the human beings after the human beings are mentioned then and the الإنسان المكلف right who is مكلف in this world the trees not مكلف the mountains not مكلف it's the human being التكليف is when you're given an amana trust responsibility and you will be watched whether you will fulfill it or not and so the human being is mukallaf. Al-ma'mur al-manhi. He's commanded with things, forbidden from certain things. This is the taklif. So then after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ذكر باقي المخلوقات. The rest of the creation of Allah. So he said, خلق السماوات والأرض. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the heavens and the earth. أي أجرامهما. أجرام every single matter in the heavens and the earth. وجميع ما فيهما. That means the earth itself and what constitutes the heavens and everything in it, living and non-living. فأحسن خلقهما. He perfected the creation of the heavens and the earth for whatever job it's created for. And that's why بالحق خلق السماوات والأرض بالحق, in the truth or by the truth. What is the meaning of بالحق? He says أي بالحكمة والغاية المقصودة له تعالى, with the wisdom and the objective that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala willed for the creation of the heavens and earth for a reason. What's the objective of it? Is the ibadah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is bilhaq. It's not created for play or for nothing. So, and also bilhaq, خلق السماوات والأرض بالحق, that means he's the creator of the heavens and the earth in truth. But he created it for the truth. That means it's not for nothing, as the disbelievers, they think, created it for nothing like this, for them to eat and drink and play. And no, created it for a reason, and that is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وصوركم فأحسن صوركم. صوركم shaped you. The surah is the image. And what really the surah is when is the image of the person, is the naqsh, as they say, when, you know, the details of the human being that is different from one to the other. No one is look like the other one. So this, your surah, your picture, your image is different than the image of someone else. So not all the human beings, they look the same. Everyone has his unique image. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sawwarakum. He's the one that fashioned you in whatever way that he created you subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَأَحْسَنَ صُوَرَكُمْ. So your suwar, your image is perfected. Perfected to fulfill the purpose of your existence. And that's why, for example, the human beings, when they enter the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they will be in a more perfect state. A body that would never dies, would be perfect. So what does that mean then? Is it perfect here? Yes, it's perfect for the earth. If someone, the same way that he will be in Jannah, to live on the earth in the same body or the same physical appearance in this world, it would not work. You know, as the, even the hadith of the Prophet والسلام, if one of the hul'in just look into the earth, right, then the entire earth will be sweet and beautiful and things like this. If you just look at it, right? So it's, this life is not the Jannah. This is the life or the place of trials. So there has to be evil and good and the choice for people to do good or evil. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fashioned and imaged everyone and created everyone for the perfect purpose that they're in. Even if someone is born with, we call it deficiencies, or with one legs, or without eyesight and all of that, this is perfect creation of Allah for that individual. He is being tested with this. And the aqibah, we always talk about the end of things. So, and it's different than someone else. So someone is being tested with being physically looking nice versus someone that it doesn't. That's human beings. How human beings, they classify things. But to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, everyone is perfectly created for the purpose of their life. And part of that is to be test to one another. And it's also mentioned in the Quran, وَرَفَعْ بَعْضَكُمْ فَوْقَ بَعْضٍ دَرَجَاتٍ لِيَتَّخِذَ بَعْضُكُمْ بَعْضًا سُخْرِيًّا. That he made you in this life. One is higher than the other. According whether it's foolish ways of the human beings, they make superior what and inferior what and things like this. Or someone is richer and someone is poorer, someone has authority, someone doesn't have authority. So all of these levels, so that people are tested. So that's why there will be dhulm, there will be injustices, there will be mockery, there will be backbiting, there will be fear of one another. All of these things, a'mal and actions, that a person will be either rewarded or punished for it. And it's all part of the test in this life. So therefore, everyone is perfectly created and imaged according to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from them, as every individual. And also in general, the human race, how we have the body that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us in, it's perfectly fashioned for, again, the purpose of our life, if it's even in the most perfect way. And Ibn Qayyim and others, when they talk in details, and we talked about that before, right? Like, for example, the way you eat, not like the animals, you go on the ground and you put your face on the ground and eat. No, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمَ. You pick the food, right? And it's perfectly easy going like this, not missing, you know, and it's not like stiff, right? You can't get the food because it's That's why you have joints. And this is every single part of the human body of a person. Reflect upon this. It's created for a reason, for a purpose, for them to establish the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is a part of the verse that, you know, person can expand on and reflect upon. So وَصَوَرَكُمْ فَأَحْسَنَ صُوَرَكُمْ. He says, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي أَحْسَنِ تَقْوِيمٍ. We created the human beings in the best taqweem. Taqweem from qama means the best stature, the best physical being. And we are not just physical being, we have our ruh, our soul in it. Right? And this is the relationship also between the physical being and one's nafs and one's soul and that amazing creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he says, فَالْإِنسَانُ أَحْسَنَ الْمَخْلُوقَاتِ سُورَةً. The human beings are the best of the creation of Allah in its image. وَأَبْهَاهَا مَنْظَرًا. Very looking. Al-baha is when something is honored or something is have a good look. وَإِلَيْهِ الْمَصِيرُ. And to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-masir, the end of things, the return. That means al-masir, al-marji' يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. So everyone will return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَيُجَازِيكُمْ. He would recompense you, give you the reward. عَلَى إِيمَانِكُمْ وَكُفْرِكُمْ. Why he mentioned إيمانكم وكفركم here? Because the previous ayah هو الذي خلقكم فمنكم كافر ومنكم مؤمن. He's the one that created you. Among you are believers and others are disbelievers. And that's why it's, you know, when you look even at the life of many people, a person is born in as the believers and he lives as a believer and he dies as a believer. Someone else is born being among the disbelievers. And he lives as a disbeliever, he dies as a disbeliever. Someone born as a believer and then his wal'iyadhu billah becomes a disbeliever and he dies as a disbeliever. Or someone born as a disbeliever, not born as a disbeliever, but he was among the disbelievers and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided him. So all of that is by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So therefore, ilayhi al-masir, and you will be rewarded or punished according to your iman and kufr. That's it. There's no other criteria in the day of judgment. It won't matter whether you are the citizen of this country or citizen of another country, whether you're black or white or tall or short. All of these things, it doesn't matter. The only thing will be in the Day of Judgment, al-Iman wal-Kufr. And what comes under the categories of al-Iman wal-Kufr. So this is what needs to be the concern and not the other things that does not make any or no benefit or no significance to it in the Day of Judgment. ويسألكم عن النعم والنعيم. And you will be asked about the favors of Allah and the delight. الذي أولاكموه. Because we're going word by word with the tafsir. أولاكموه. How can you translate أولاكموه? You know, we took the ayah النبي أولى بالمؤمنين أنفسهم. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم have more rights on the believers. But أولاكموه, that means he gave this to you. أولاكم, that the na'im and the delight that Allah bestowed upon you. هل قمتم بشكري? Did you fulfill the gratefulness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with all of these favors that Allah gave you? أم لم تقوموا بشكري? Or you did not fulfill the gratefulness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So this is what the ayah says. خلق السماوات والأرض بالحق. So the gratefulness because it's created in truth and for the truth. It's not created for nothing. وَصَوَّرَكُمْ فَأَحْسَنَ صُوَرَكُمْ. So where is the shukr? Where is the gratefulness? وَإِلَيْهِ الْمَصِيرُ. And to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-masir, is the return. يَعْلَمُ مَا فِي السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَيَعْلَمُ مَا تُسِرُّونَ وَمَا تُعْلِنُونَ وَاللَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِذَاتِ الصُّدُورِ. Which means he knows what's in the heavens and on earth, and he knows what you conceal and what you reveal, and Allah is the all-knower of what is in the breasts of men. So here the ilm. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ya'lamu ma fi as-samawati wal-ard. So he's the creator of the heavens and earth, and of course the knowledge of what's in the heavens and earth only to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And al-ilm here, he says min as-sara'ir wal-dhawahir wal-ghayb wal-shahada. The secrets, the inward things that you have, your whims, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows it, and what appears to other human being or other creation of Allah. والغيب والشهادة, the unseen and the seen. There is no unseen to Allah. The الغيب is to us, غيب to us. And الشهادة is to us, what we see versus what we do not see. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his knowledge encompasses everything. and the future and the past and the impossible and everything. He is Al-Alim subhanahu wa ta'ala. يَعْلَمُ مَا فِي السَّمَوَاتِ وَأَرْضُ وَلِذَلِكَ And because of that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala link any time you see any means of the rububiyyah of Allah, the lordship of Allah, or the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, link that to the purpose of life, to the ubudiyyah that we are commanded to observe. So as a result of that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَلَا يَعْلَمُ مَنْ خَلَقَ وَهُوَ اللَّطِيفُ الْخَبِيرُ Doesn't Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows His creation? So that means He knows His creation more than anyone else. So when the ahkam, when the rulings comes from Allah, comes from the creator of the heavens, and the one that created us. So do you know better what's for you or what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded? وَيَعْلَمُ مَا تُسِرُّونَ وَمَا تُعْلِنُونَ And He knows what's تُسِرُّونَ الْإِسْرَارِ is the sir, is the secrets. وَمَا تُعْلِنُونَ And what you make apparent and you make it public and you openly say it. أي بِمَا فِيهَا مِنَ الْأَسْرَارِ He knows what's all secrets, whether it's الطيبة, good secrets, not all secrets are evil. والخبايا الخبيثة and الخبايا is what's hidden. خبيثة, impure, wicked. Human beings are very complex, right? So a person can be right next to you, speaking to you, smiling and everything like this, but inside he carries so much hatred, so much envy, so much, and this is inside. Allah knows this. And that's why this can never be perceived from a believer. Because the as you know that the Prophet ﷺ, whenever he would give the pledge of al-Islam to someone, and by the way, this is one of the things that we need to at first teach when someone becomes a Muslim. Because the Prophet ﷺ used to take that from the very first instance that they became Muslims. Bay'ah, part of the bay'ah, والنصح لكل مسلم. That he has to have the concern towards every Muslim. Now he's part of that ummah. Not that he wants evil for them, he wants the best for them. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what's in the secrets. والخبايا الخبيثة والنيات الصالحة, the good intentions, والمقاصد الفاسدة, the corrupted objectives. You know, a person is saying something, but he's plotting. He wants something that a person, other person doesn't know. فإذا كان عليما بذات الصدور, والله عليم بذات الصدور. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the unknower of what's inside of the, الصدر is the breast, but it refers to the heart. This is the container where the heart is in. So if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala like this, تعين على العاقل البصير. Now he talks about the outcome, the benefit of this. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what's inside of the hearts and what's one's thoughts and whims and everything, then تعين, you know, فرض عين, that means becomes an obligation upon العاقل البصير, the one with reason, the one that has the proper vision, and يحرص, listen to this carefully, what is the benefit here? Wallahu alimun bidati sudur. Allah knows what's in the hearts. So the person, the wise one, and yahris, that he is so diligent and so eager, ويجتهد and strive and struggle في حفظ باطني, to guard his باطن, to guard his inward part, not the outward part. Everybody take care of their outside appearance, even as Muslims, right? We make sure that everything physically, you know, this is for someone that wants to be upon the deen. We make sure that the outside appearance is part of the deen, which is we should. And we have to be very strict with this. But the same way or even more than that. More than that should be the heart. A person has to يَجْتَهِدْ فِي حِفْظِ بَاطِنِهِ Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees what's in the heart. And we will be questioned about what's in the heart. The whims, no. I mean, a person doesn't have responsibility for it. That's why intentions, the deed are not accepted unless it's with ikhlas. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَنْظُرُ إِلَى صُوَرِكُمْ Suwar is mentioned in the ayah, right? Allah does not look at your suwar, at your image, at how you look. وَلَا إِلَى أَجِسَامِكُمْ And not to your physical bodies. Because you're all creation of Allah, you don't have a say in it. You did not make a decision of how you look. This is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He's the most wise. ولكن but rather ينظر he looks at إلى قلوبكم and your outside appearance no your قلوبكم your hearts وأعمالكم and your actions so what matters of your outside appearance is the actions so basically when we perfect our salah when we perfect our physical actions these are actions and so, and the heart is the foundation of it So this is wallahu alimu bi dhati sudur. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best what's in the hearts, that a person has to work and to be eager and to fix and to guard his batin. And this is the concern of the shaitan. Shaitan, his concern is to enter the heart. And Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah and others, they mention all kinds of things where the shaitan is waiting, you know, to get a chance to enter. Right? And the shaitan, he runs in the bloodstream. So you have to protect yourself. And any chance he gets, he will go in. And he has manafid. He goes through the eyesight. So what you listen, Quran is shaitan, is the singing and the songs and all of these things. He goes in with what a person sees of sins, he goes in. And once he's there, then he can easily beautify the evil, because the heart is now can be manipulated, person easily deceived. So the work of purifying the heart with the book of Allah, with matters of al-Iman, من الأخلاق الرذيلة, from the wicked manners, واتصافه بالأخلاق الجميلة, and to adorn the heart with the beautiful أخلاق and manners. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the secrets. خلق السماوات والأرض بالحق وصوركم فأحسن صوركم وإليه المصير, the day of judgment. And he يعلم ما في السماوات والأرض ويعلم ما تسرون وما تعلنون والله عليم بذات الصدور. Then we have 3 minutes left, but we'll take just one verse. Even this next verse depends on it, the next one. ألم يأتيكم نبأ الذين كفروا من قبل فذاقوا وبال أمرهم ولهم عذاب أليم, which means has not the news reached you of those who disbelieved aforetime, and so they tasted the evil result of their disbelief, and theirs will be a painful torment. So hereafter, وإليه المصير, and to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, everyone shall return. And before that, Allah بما تعملون بصير, in the second ayah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows, is the all seer of what you do. And also in the previous verse, يعلم ما تسرون, and he knows what you secretly have and openly. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the disbelievers. He says here, لما ذكر تعالى من أوصافه الكاملة العظيمة, the great attributes of Allah, ما به يعرف ويعبد, for people to know Allah and to worship Him alone, وببذل الجهد في مرضاته, and to strive and to put the best effort to seek the pleasure of Allah, وتجنب مساخطه, and to stay away from what bring the wrath of Allah, أخبر بما فعل بالأمم السابقين, Allah informs what He did with the nations before, والقرون الماضين, the previous generations, الذين لم تزل أنباؤهم يتحدث بها المتأخرون, the ones that أنباؤهم, their news continuously, the متأخرون, the later generations always talk about them, about what happened to the nations before, ويخبر بها الصادقون, and the truthful ones always inform about them, وأنهم حين جاءتهم رسل بالحق, when the messengers came to them with the truth, كذبوهم وعندوهم, they denied them, they stubbornly opposed them, فأذاقهم الله وبال أمرهم في الدنيا. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made them taste the wabal of their actions. And the wabal is a su', is the evil thing that a person hates so much. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made them فذاقوا, they tasted وبال أمرهم, they tasted the su' and the evil and what they hate of their وَبَالَ أَمْرِهِمْ, أَمْرِهِمْ here is their حال, their state. So when a person is upon evil state, this is basically what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَذَاقُوا وَبَالَ أَمْرِهِمْ, they tasted the evil that they hate of their state. So when a person has a wicked state, evil intentions, things like this, he will taste it. It's not going to be let go unless he repents to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the punishment in the hereafter. في الدنيا وأخزاهم فيها, make them disgraced, ولهم عذاب أليم, they have painful punishment in the day of judgment. ألم يأتكم, haven't reached you, نبأ, the news, الذين كفروا, those who disbelieved من قبل, and the Quran is full of that, فذاقوا وبال أمرهم, sorry, past tense, they tasted the evil outcome of their actions, ولهم عذاب أليم, ذلك بأنه كانت تأتيهم رسلهم بالبينات فقالوا أبشر يهدوننا فكفروا وتولوا واستغنى الله والله غني حميد. We'll just we'll go through this inshallah ta'ala tomorrow, but the translation, that was because there came to them their messengers with clear proofs and signs, but they said, shall mere men guide us? So they disbelieved and turned away, and Allah was not in need of them, and Allah is rich, worthy of all praise. So what happened to the nations before when they disbelieved? This is the reason why they're punished. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned why the wabal, why did they taste the evil of their actions? Because of this, that the messengers came to them with the clear proofs. So instead of submitting themselves, they said, أَبَشَرُوا يَهْدُونَا. Other human beings will guide us. فَكَفَرُوا. They disbelieved, وَتَوَلَّوا, and then turned away. وَاسْتَغْنَى اللَّهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most rich. Imam Sa'di said some things here, but we'll talk about that inshallah ta'ala tomorrow because of the time. So we'll stop here inshallah. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Alhamdulillah. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. سبحانك اللهم ربنا وبحمدك اشهد ان لا اله الا انت استغفرك واتوب اليك